Welcome along.
I'm chatting with history. The past is the present. And chatting about famous moments in history. So please help me welcome our host, Hollywood Paradise.
Thank you. Welcome to our show, everybody. Hey, it's great to be here. This is Jess. Thanks for that great announcement. I want to welcome everyone to my show, Chatting with History. Boy, we got an exciting show today. We have wonderful people from throughout history that are really going to knock your socks off. As you know, Mrs. S, it's Oscar season. Last night we had our Academy Awards, and they were filled with history. History from the early 1930s to history throughout earlier time periods. And we just love to talk about history on our show. So I would like to introduce our first guest for today. Our first guest today is named Nathan. He comes all the way back from the late 1800s in a place called Pea Island. And he was responsible for helping lots of people during a big storm. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my first guest, Nathan. Nathan, welcome to Chatting with History.
Thank you for having me here. It's an honor.
Well, first I want to ask you, how old are you? Do you mind me asking?
Well, I'm only 12 years old, so I don't mind if everyone knows my age.
Okay. I hear that you've been living on Pea Island for half of your life. Have you had any difficulties there?
Yes, there were some difficult times, but I haven't been there for most of them because I've been only living on Pea Island since I was six. Although I remember when the big hurricane came, it almost killed four people.
Really?
That day and night, we had to stay at the Pea Island station because our house is made of wood, so everything kept on getting wet and caving in.
Wow. What's one experience that you had on Pea Island that you could share with us on Chatting with History?
Well, I remembered when my grandpa died. He said he was going to die when I grew up, when I was an adult. But he didn't. He died this year. That day, I buried him next to my house and also worked extra hard just for him.
I hear that you sometimes rescue people in storms. What are some qualities you have to do such a thing?
Well, you have to be brave and strong, because in storms like the hurricane, it can knock you down. When I was out in the storm, it knocked me down.
Nathan, I know that you're an adventurous boy. What was one of your adventures?
One of my adventures was when I was sneaking into the Pea Island station.
Oh.
And I borrowed two of the books, but no one knew.
I think you mean stole, but I'm not going to say that. So Nathan, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a surfman or a fisherman. All the surfmen on the island inspire me to become a surfman because they care more to other people than themselves. My dad inspires me to become a fisherman because fishermen get to explore the ocean and see all different animals.
Hey, thanks again for coming. It was a pleasure having you. I hope you can come again.
No, I must thank you for having me come. It was a pleasure having me.
That's it, folks. Let's hear it for Nathan. We're back to Chatting with History, and our next guest is somebody from the 1940s during one of the biggest and most important wars of our time. It was World War II, and my next guest is named Madeline Beck. She lived in Long Island, New York, and she's going to talk about what it was like living through such a big war. Let's give it up for Madeline Beck. Okay, Madeline, welcome. You lived through World War II. What was it like for you in 1942, with your father being in the war? Were you afraid that he might be hurt or even killed?
Well, when my father went to war, my mom and I had to move to a mansion by the sea, but it was really no mansion, it was a boarding house. So, and there was many of us like sharing a very small space. And I was my mom and I were actually very scared that my father would get hurt and even killed. And we would, every time we saw a telegram, we would get scared that we'd get bad news about my father. and we actually had two telegrams, and the first one actually said that my father was critically wounded and in the San Francisco hospital. And the next telegram actually said he was okay and recovering.
Wow, that's amazing. You did something called a K3F Club. Do you want to talk about that?
Sure. Well, the K3F Club is the Kids Fight for Freedom, where we started at school, and it's where kids join together to help soldiers in the war, and only 6-year-olds or 13-year-olds were only allowed to be in it. And we did lots of things, and one of them was look out for German U-boats along the coast.
Wow, that is incredible. I can't believe kids were doing such things. Do you think that you did anything to change any of the events during World War II, Madeline?
Well, maybe. I mean, one day, Johnny and I, my best friend, were walking on the beach, and we spotted seaweed by the dune, so we went to go check it out. And I picked up the seaweed, and we saw a hole which had Nazi uniforms and Nazi bombs. So after that, I made a call to the FBI, and they recovered 4 Nazis trying to destroy transportation networks.
Oh my God, that's amazing. Madeline, during a war, a hard time such as that, is there anything you can do for fun?
Well, I do a lot of things for fun. Like, I do a lot of things with my friend Johnny. Like, we have go walks on the beach, we have a secret code, we do our K3F club, and I actually write to my dad a lot and keep a diary.
Wow. Madeline, my audience wants to know, what did you do once the war was over?
Well, after the war was over, I went over to San Francisco where my father was to visit him. And after my senior year in high school, I went back to New York and I got engaged and married to Johnny.
Everyone?
We moved to Washington, D.C. and Johnny worked for National Geographic and I worked for American Red Cross.
Oh, I gotta tell you, Madeline, it's been a pleasure. I want to thank you for being here today and sharing your life with us. It's been a real pleasure. Once again, Madeline Beck. Hey, we're going to come right back and you'll see more interviews from more historical figures. Our next guest on Chatting with History is somebody that survived a very difficult time in history. This person survived slavery in the 1800s. Her name is Rosalia, and she's going to share her story. Please welcome Rosalia.
Why, hello, Mr. Paradise. It is a pleasure to meet you. I am glad to be on your show, and it's true, I am a slave.
So, Rosalia, I hear you live in the 1800s. What is it like to be a servant?
It was horrible. I would wake up very, very early in the morning and do lots of chores and make breakfast or all sorts of stuff.
That seems really hard. Rosalia, what was the best thing that happened to you during your life?
Well, the best thing was when Senior Johnston took me to a store and got me a block of ink for my journal. I was so happy.
You must really love ink. So, Rosalia, you went to another ranch to become another person's slave? How could you stay strong like that?
I would stay as strong as possible, and it's something I have to say yes to.
Interesting. So, Rosa, what do you like to do for fun?
I just love writing in my journal. It's so fun to do.
Rosa, what do you want to do or become in your future?
I want to get married and be a famous writer and have kids.
Wow, that sounds exciting. Amazing. Well, Rosa and Leah, we're out of time. So, we'll see you next time on Chatting with History.
Thank you, Mr. Paradise, for letting me on the show. Well, goodbye.
Everybody, say goodbye to Rosa and Leah.